I think this is silly. I think asking me for advice is really a funny idea. But that's what we're going to do. You're going to ask me for advice, and I'm going to tell you in a very unrestrained fashion what I think the answer is. Alrighty. Do you still smoke weed? If so, how do you care for your throat and your vocal cords? As a singer-songwriter, I won't smoke on the day of a concert. I rarely have a problem, but just knowing there is a magic elixir lozenge to drink or to go with if needed would be cool. I can't explain why my voice is working the way it is. It's working very well. My friends who really don't butter my toast tell me that I'm singing as well as I ever have in my life. And I smoke pot all the time. I smoke it every day. Well, every night. I try not to smoke it in the daytime because I have shit to do. I don't see any problem smoking weed. I don't smoke it before I go on, before I sing. But that's not because of my throat. That's because I sort of need all the brain cells that are still holding hands to be gathered up in one area when I'm trying to remember the lyrics and communicate with an audience. So I smoke afterwards. I hope that some helped you. Croz, how you doing? You're a little older than me. I'm late 60s, but I need help. My 44-year-old son died 1 year ago from fentanyl, and I can't get over it. I can't help you. You have to go on with your life. I don't know if you have other family, but if you had a kid, you've got a partner. And you got yourself. Bitter sadness, though. There is no fix. I have no fix for you. I can only be honest with you and tell you that's a terrible weight to carry. I would look for joy anywhere I could find it. Try to balance it. Sorry, I wish I could help you. Dear David, I love your music, and in my humble opinion, your recent run of 4 albums in 5 years are up there with the best of your work. The thing is, my wife will only listen to George Michael and Rick Astley. How do I get her to appreciate your music? Hopeless, man. Obviously, you need to get remarried. If your wife is resistant, I mean, how can she resist the magnificence of my music? It's so stunning. Try smoking a joint with your wife and then see if she likes my music better. Somehow those two things seem to work together, my music and joints. Try that. Hello and thanks. I'm curious about how you managed to keep such a positive and upbeat attitude in the face of your illnesses over the years. I've had and have several serious health diagnoses, and there are days I just feel so less than I did from 5 years ago mentally and physically. Did you have days like this? And if so, how did you address those feelings? Physical stuff is really tough. Yeah, I've had a lot. I did 72 days in UCLA hospital. 72 days. Dying. It is insanely difficult. First of all, do you have health care? A lot of us don't. Secondly, can they do anything? You have to find some core of strength within yourself to hold on to. Otherwise, you're going to just be adrift. David, my husband always wants me to blow him, like at least twice a week. But he refuses to go down on me. He says that is disgusting and he wants no part of it. I put up with enough of this ridiculous double standard for years, but I've had enough and I want to stop blowing him until he returns the favor. Am I being unfair? I mean, I've never performed oral sex on a woman before. Is it as gross as he says? No, I do it all the time. Isn't that gross? I think he's being very one-sided. I think you should give him the Liz Estrada treatment. Tell him, you know, I'm sorry. No goods for you. He needs to learn that women have orgasms too. So I think a short instructional thing, you know, where you get somebody to, like, explain to him where the fun button is. Because he maybe he doesn't know. It's right there at the... If you have to explain it, you got a problem anyway.